Hey, welcome back to No Man's Sky. This is The Spear. And as you can tell, we are at a space station. And we are playing with the new update, the Pathfinder update. As you can tell, the space station to me looks a little bit sharper. Everything looks sharper. The glass on the bottom looks a little more shiny. The lights look better. The colors are different. This looks really good. They really improved the look of everything. Immensely. You might want to be wondering what we're doing up here. We had a little recording error. With the Pathfinder update, I wanted to get a base. We need a base. Really, the Pathfinder update without a base is not much of an update. So instead, we started out a little tiny base. I think we just have built one room in addition to the original one. And we just hired a teleport unavailable. The teleportation network is only available to experienced warp travelers. Well, that's very disappointing because I didn't want to use a lot of plutonium taking off and landing again. But it appears that I will be using a lot of plutonium. That's not good. Use as little as we can, but yeah, so I'm gonna use this. There's our base. Our base would be right there. We're on the same planet. We're on the same moon. Sorry, not planet. We're right where we were before. They've changed the ruin is purple. That's how it always used to be. Okay, that was a weird. That was a weird sign they were giving me. You always get the white. The white is the base. It's giving me some green thing, which I'm not sure what that means. The green with the two stripes. Oh. But anyway, so here. Oh. Well, I was planning on landing right next to the door, but it didn't want me to do that. But look at this planet. This planet looks a lot different than it did before, and I think a lot better. I mean, just look at it. It looks so much nicer. Well, so much more crisp and vibrant than it did before. And it's really amazing how different it looks. Really amazing. And we'll get more into the views as we cross. Alright, so I don't, why is that? Okay, so that's the green part, but it was also giving me the white part for base. Alright, here's our guy, Fra, Assistant Fra. We hired him at the space station to help me make a base. I'll provide the blueprint for any construction item you need, but before you start running around the galaxy in search of resources, allow me to present you with this beacon blueprint. So we can do a beacon. Thank you. Not sure how this beacon is going to help me at this time, but maybe in the future. I don't know how to make either one of those. Oh no, I know how to make carrot sheets. Alright. Okay, Assistant Fra, what else you got for me? The spadonium I need to create a science terminal's diagnostic sample extracted from cacti. That is correct. 50 spadonium. And there was spadonium on our very first planet. Gotcha. On our very first planet, there was spadonium. And we will get to that. But to get back to our very first planet, we're going to need a hyperdrive. Well, fuel for the hyperdrive. Is this broken? And this is not even repaired. Oh my. Alright, first we need a dynamic resonator to repair that. And we don't know how to make a dynamic resonator. All right.
Wow.
Okay, we can make a warp cell. You start with suspension fluid, then make electron vapor, then make antimatter, then make the warp cell. So we can make the warp cell, but we need to repair the ship first. Our Class C shuttle. This is a new thing in the game, Class C shuttle. There's A, B, C, and S. S is, I believe, the best. And I'm going to assume that C is pretty good, even though you would think A, B, C, A is the best. I'm not sure, but the other things go by sigma, tau, and theta, and the third one is always the best, so I'm going to say A, B, C, C is the best. This is a shuttle. They have fighters, they have explorers, they have haulers, and each ship has a different class bonus, I believe, and things like that. But we need to repair. Also, with the guns, here we are with a rifle. I'm not sure the other types of rifles or the other types of multi-tools. I know there's a there's an alien one, which is supposedly the best, or the most exotic, or the most rare, or something about it is good. And there's two other styles. I'm not sure their names. One of them is very good at scanning, and one of them is very good at... good question. I don't know. Am I good at mining? Am I good at shooting things? I'm not sure. But that's that. And nothing. But we have here nanite clusters. We need a lot of those. All right. So they want me to go to get spadonium, which is disappointing. It's very disappointing. Let's see what blueprints this guy has for me to augment my base. New. New building styles. All kinds of new things. But we're not really. Nip nip, what? A medicinal herb. Not exactly sure what that would do for me. Race? Oh, that's when you start and race your exocraft. I want to build a... I thought we could already do this. But apparently now we have to buy the technology. I thought we could already do some of these things, but apparently not. Okay, so I need more rooms and more buildings. Fine. Let's build another room. In here we will put we already have construction. The exocraft terminal. You can recruit technicians and space stations. That's right. We're going back to the space station and we're going to get somebody to build me an exocraft. Ooh, you can already see the picture right there. I wouldn't mind driving one of those around, checking out, seeing what happens. But the problem is, every time we take off to fly to the space station, it's going to cost us more and more plutonium. And that's going to be a problem. Temperature levels stabilizing. All right, so it looks like it's just before dawn. Oh, there was a fair amount of pop-in. I thought the pop-in issues had been settled, but I guess not. There's this new, I don't know what you call it. Detritum. Anyway, a new exotic mining laser. So there's some new things to life mine. Oh, running out of life support again. Let's just see if there's anything around. It doesn't look like there's anything around. Question. Human is away to something. Well, I tell you what, let's go over there. and not sure what it might be. Well, I have no idea what it might be. We're going to see if it's something. Because on the way there or back, I might pick up some plutonium. Although I'm not exactly running out of plutonium. But if I keep going back and forth to the space station and I warp into other systems to get the spadonium, it's going to really use up my resources quickly. And we don't want that. Heck, for all I know, I'm going to walk another minute and then they'll tell me where another crashed ship is. Or maybe they'll sell me a dynamic resonator. We cannot even warp without a dynamic resonator. I think we can buy one at the space station. We can buy one. But we have 71,000, so we should be able to buy one. We have 71,000 units. I don't know how much a dynamic resonator would cost, but I'm guessing less than that. I'm hoping less than that. We shall see. Look at the planet. The moon, it looks so different than it did when we were walking before. It's so much better. You don't know what those numbers are that pop out of things that you shoot? But numbers now pop out of things that you shoot. I think I can turn them off, and I think I will. Oh, it's a... it's an exosuit. And I don't have enough units to get the exosuit. Ooh, that could be a little dangerous. So without the units, there's no point, really. I'm just going to go down and get the crate. There are usually crates. Yeah, see, there's three crates. Oh, there's three crates, so that'll give me some money. I sell what's in them. Alright, life support. And this is my last power canister. Technology recharge. Oh. Corvax Convergence Cube. Those are worth some money. Keknip. And Ragra. Alright. Now what I'm not going to do, I'm not going to save here and claim this the biome. Biome. I'm not going to do that because I want the question mark to still show up on my scanners. Because if I do get enough credits, I'm going to want to come back here and get this exosuit upgrade. It's 110,000 units. The last one was 100,000. So this one will be 110,000, then 120,000, then 130,000. So you really gotta get into money-making mode if you wanna upgrade suits and stuff. All right, so now the long trek back. We're gonna take a slightly different route than we did here, see if there's anything. There's some plutonium. Do we have room? Yeah, plutonium 4. Plenty of room for plutonium, copper, thamium. Copper, carbon. That's it, one little spot. Well, it's not so cool, but... Look up. This looks very different to me. Much better. It looks really great. And if you're following No Man's Sky on their website or Twitter, there's been some really great pictures taken of the new Pathfinder. It looks really good in space. It looks really good on the ground. There's not much around, is there? They did say that they adjusted the minerals and things that you would find in survival and permadeath mode. I don't know what adjusted means. More? Less? Well, it's either more or less, but it's not the same. I don't know if it's more or less. I'm currently thinking it's less. But it might just be my location. The Corvex, you're giving me a virus! Oh wait, no, that's the word for virus. Got it. I can't wait to get into one of those, exo-vehicles? I forget what they call them. We're gonna go up to the space station. We're gonna hire a guy, a Viking, to help me build the different vehicles to get around the planet, the moon. When I understand they're very fast, they got a lot of storage, so, and some kind of mining beam. So it's got all kinds of stuff we could use. All right, so let's get it. Hundred more plutonium.
Technology recharge.
Alright, I need to buy a dynamic resonator, hire that guy, sell some things. Not gonna buy any of that. I may have to dismantle that. Space looks so good. You can see much of it since we're going straight to the space station. Spadoni. Thanks for coming to find Spadoni. Come out of the spaceships in a starships in a different location, like right off the nose. That's good. You don't come off to the side anymore. I think they also made it where you won't fall down a cliff on your way out. All right, this is where we hired Assistant Fra, and we talked to this guy, Conscript Yurnak. Yurnak. Oh, what are you gonna do? But this conscript demands a place on my throne world. Exocraft and Viking mech priest. I accept your services. Give me that exocraft. You are weak and unworthy of my skills, but I have no choice. I will flee to your vile planet base. Let's sell what we got. $13,000 for the conversions cube, $20,000 for the Geknip, $21,000 for the Gragra. Nice. Now I have more than enough. $126,000. I can get another exosuit. But I need to buy a dynamic resonator. $34,000. Come on. Now I can no longer get that exosuit, but I can repair my hyperdrive.
Technology repaired. No free slots.
And we've got what, five free slots. That's doing good. All right, so now I can warp back. Expansion fluid. Electron vapor. Antimatter. warp shell. Actually, I'll need two of them. Because presumably I want to come back here. Huh. Alright, so this is it. Oh, there's a little change. It tells you exactly what you'll get from technology. Beam impact signal will increase my damage that I give to other ships at 40 to 40. I'm not sure what that number actually represents. Cannon damage will increase my damage from the cannon by 100. Damage potential right now is 1344. Accelerated fire increases the rate of fire by 20%. Oh. Ooh. All right, so that's not bad. So you learn a little bit more there. Let's get some iron. Pulse engine's charged up. I freed up a lot of slots now, but that just means I'm running out of things. Things I don't necessarily want to run out of. Like plutonium. But alright. But that's good, though. I don't have enough money. Alright, so you're going to the base. Should I go to the base, or should I go to get the spadonium? Oh. If I go to the base, he could tell me what I need to get these exocrafts. But I would waste plutonium. We're gonna warp. And hope that I've remembered the correct place. Yes, that's me. That's where I am. But I would like to... not free. Oops. That's not... I'd like to go back to where I was. Have a waypoint. No. Wait. I saw something flash up on the map there. Yes, this is where I started. Okay. Which planet did I start on? Not sure which one of those three planets I started on. Remember, that's where I started. Ooh. Warping is a little different. I think the colors are the same, but if you look at the ship is weird. It's like blurry and flashy. It's a little bit interesting. So it looks like they've really changed everything. Well, if you change the way something looks, it does, I guess, change everything. Final journey? I'm already on my final journey. They want me to look at the vehicles. Gather 50 spadonium. Got it. Here's our discoveries. Snowy, balmy, toxic rain. That's where we were. We want you to go to Abu Dhabi. That's where we started. How can I miss this big thing? No, that's not it either. Well, I tell you what, why don't they make something where you can go from the... It should make it where you're, if you're looking at the list of planets and you say, I want to go there, it should automatically say, it should be a nice tip. And I think a computer could do that. Computers know where planets are, and I think you should be able to go from the list of planets to facing your planet. This is where we started. We're back home again. Unfortunately. I didn't really care for this toxic planet. Oh no, wait a second. Am I going to be able to get the spadonium? Alright, it just says get spadonium. I'm hoping I don't need any extra tools to get the spadonium. Because that would be disappointing, to say the least. Fly all the way here and then not be able to get it. I didn't say anything. See, now look how this looks different too. All the blue lines and the asteroids would seem to fly right through. Oh, 15 seconds. No, I'm not gonna make it. Fly faster. Not fast enough. I'll tell you what, this is a lot easier than, famous last words. Wow! I can't believe I got two of them. On survival mode, I had expected to not survive that. It didn't help crashing into things. Novice. Cool. Is that where I was going? No. Well, now I'm lost again. There we go. Nice! I can't believe I got two of those things down. And the shields were not, they were damaged a bit, but not too bad. What can I craft? Can I craft a shield? Shards. I can only craft shards. Well, I'm happy to survive that. It worked out pretty well. I'm really surprised. Maybe I got some extra tech on. No, these are all broken. But hey, I'm with what's going on. I really hope this is the planet that's going. Because if I was on a place with spadonium, I just didn't look around. There's something ahead of us. Alright, that's good enough. Waypoint will tell us where things are. Back where we started from. Whoever thought we'd be here? But this is where we'll leave it for now. Next time we're going to pick up the spadonium. We're going to go back and check out our base, the Atlas. Find us. Hear us. And we're going to go check out the base next time and see what our construction guy can do, and we're going to get those exocraft. We're going to hopefully be able to drive around our moon. That would be pretty cool to try that out. But for now, we're going to call this a day. This is The Spear. Hope you enjoyed No Man's Sky Survival. See you next time.